We are going to set up the plugin from Dynamic.oo for this one. And they have this add-on where you could enable a PDF download for your content. Hi, Danica here. And in this video, we are going to set up the plugin from Dynamic.oo for this one. And they have this add-on where you could enable a PDF download for your content. So I just downloaded the file and I'm gonna install that right now as a plugin and then click activate. So I'm gonna deactivate everything in here and I'm just gonna make sure that is saved, and I'm gonna find the PDF. So I'm gonna turn this to on, save widget. Okay, so now that that is on, we're gonna go ahead and add that download button. So on our results page here, let's edit that. So I'm just gonna open that. And then, so let's look for the PDF button. And then select JS, leave that default. Select the title of your file. For now, I'm gonna leave it as post name, but you could customize it if you want. And then we need to change this to, for the, like example, if you have a specific class ID, you could also do like class ID. And then of course that class ID is the one that you will enter here. So class ID. But for this example, I don't need that because I don't have anything in the page. So I'm gonna leave it at says body. And that's it. So I'm just gonna change the button color. So it is white. And let's test the button. So refresh. Download PDF. So it should download the file, and of course after that you can see that the page has been fully converted to a PDF. Again, you could be more fancy with this one and only download specific section of your website. It doesn't need to be the whole body. You just need to make sure you set the HTML container ID name and of course set the section or container ID. So the one that I showed earlier. So you just need to change this part. Whatever ID name you set that is example. If you only want this, let's just say this container, you only want that to be downloaded and don't include the upper one, then set the CSS ID name in here as well. So that's it for this video. I hope this helps. I just found out this plugin when I was working on this project last time. So I hope this is helpful for you. And if you have any question or want to get this plugin, I'm gonna include an affiliate link below so that you can use it. So I hope this video helps and you have learned something from it. Now, if you're still feeling stuck on how to create and manage your WordPress membership site, visit us at wpmembershipdesigns.com where you can learn how we can help with your projects. And you may also book a call to determine if we are the right fit for your needs. Again, thanks for watching this video. If you have any question regarding this, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I could, or else create a separate video tutorial regarding that. That's it for this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.